Just before we get to our first guest, Armin Barekian, a couple different areas I want to cover tonight. First, CPL bits and bytes. And yes, I've been getting a lot of tweets, a lot of phone calls, text messages, emails nonstop for the last month and a bit. Anthony, when's the press conference happening? Anthony, when are we going to get going? Anthony, how many teams? Anthony. Guys and gals out there, sit tight. Things are happening. Relax, I'm just as anxious as you out there. There's information I have I cannot tweet out. I cannot right now discuss here on air. I'd love to, but it's getting really close. And as a matter of fact, I think you should watch my Twitter this week at @ForTotera. I'll be giving out a little tidbit, a little important information about CPL as well. But as for the press conference or an event, maybe we should call it, that's coming down. That will happen very, very soon. And I believe that you will have an announcement or a press conference, an event, however way you want to call it, hopefully by mid-October, one way or another, an announcement of some sort at an event or a press conference will take place. But I put together some bits and bytes. And let's start thinking about some of these things out there in Canada. And I want your feedback. And I want to hear from you out there, coaches, players, supporters. I want to hear from you out there. I put together a few things that I thought, if we're going to make this league a success, where I worked back in the day in the Canadian Soccer League, it was a success to a certain point. But then, unfortunately, it went right off the rails and the roller coaster ride ended. And so I want to make sure that this ride lasts forever and ever. And even when I'm gone, it's here for my grandkids, and it continuously goes on stronger and stronger. And so I think we need to think outside of the box. I really believe we need to start thinking about today's supporters, today's millennials, today's young kids and what they like. And I'm not saying to really go crazy and start implementing crazy rules and do, all sorts of wild things. No. We have to start thinking outside the box a bit. And I want to hear from you and some of your suggestions out there. Here are some of mine. I believe once CPL kicks off that we should have 5 subs each and every game. 5 subs. Why not? Tell me what's the big deal with having 5 subs. We saw what MLS just did recently. Let's one-up them. Let's do 5 subs each and every game. Now, 3 points for a win. I believe 0 points should be given for a tie. My opinion, mine only. I believe each and every game, each team should be going out there for a win. So 3 points for a win. Now, here's another one. A little pepper on that steak. How about scoring 4 goals or more in a game and you get an extra point? So if you win 4-0, 5-0, instead of 3 points, you'll get 4 points. How tasty is that? I like that. That's not crazy. Why not? Let's try that. Now, I also believe that each and every team that on the bench should be a Canadian head coach. Each and every team. At least the first year. I believe that wholeheartedly, 1,000%. Each and every team should have a Canadian on that bench. No excuses. Now, once we get into the, let's say, the second and third year, I still believe it should be implemented. It should be written in stone that there should be a Canadian on the bench, whether as an assistant or a head coach, but they need to be on that bench no matter what. Now, this one I'm sure I'm going to get a lot of feedback on, because I've been getting it since we've been talking about CPL for the last year and a bit. I believe 70%, at least 70% of all starters must be Canadian. 70%. Maybe it's a bit high, but I believe let's try with 70%. I'm willing to listen to others that might think it should be maybe 65 or 60, but I'll tell you right now, over my dead body, will I agree with 50% of Canadians being starters? No way. I didn't yell, scream, and shed tears and fight for this and sit at that table 6 years ago when these discussions were started out in this dream that 4 or 5 of us had is now coming to fruition, to only have 50% of the starters at any given game be Canadians. No way. No way. I can't live with that. I won't live with that. Now, as you know, the league grows, as the league develops, as the league gets more spotlight, and as the league demands more from its supporters, and its supporters want more, then sure, maybe we can look at it. But I believe in my heart of hearts, for the first, I'm going to say it, first 5 years at least, I believe we should have at least 70% all Canadians as starters. All Canadian starters, 70%. Now, also, I believe we should have one table and one table only. Not east and west, north and south, whatever way you want to put it. I want one table. One table and one table only. That's it. I don't want this east versus west. You know, nothing wrong the way MLS is doing it, because I understand it. Geographically, it suits them well. But for our country, I think it's best we go with one table and one only. And why? We're not going to have the amount of teams that MLS has. And that's why I believe that's another reason why they're going with East and West in MLS. We won't get to that. When we get to that point in 15 years from now, where we're bursting with teams at maybe 15, 18, 20, then we can think about it. But I would say for now, one table only. Keep going that way at least for 10 years, I would say, maybe more. But at least one table and one table only. Now, the last one I thought of, and I thought this is quite the idea, is having each and every game ball, official game ball, being the color of red. Yeah, it's crazy, but why not? Make it red. Nothing wrong with the color red. Make it all red. Red stands for many ways, the colors of our country. Maybe put a Canadian flag on each and every ball. I'm good with that. So those are some of my thinking outside of the box ideas. I'd love to hear from you out there. Would you like to see implemented? Would you like to see tried? Because we can't just have, you know, this league start up like leagues in the past have started up and be the same old, same old. You can't do that anymore. We got the millennials that you really got to cater to. We've got the older generation that still wants to come and have the old-fashioned way. We've got people like me that are open to the new way of thinking, but also like to keep the old way the way it was. So we got to do some outside-of-the-box thinking.